So the last large group of videos has been going around getting some of the awesome chocolate milk around the United States, usually only filming the good stuff. So would that trend continue down here in sunny Costa Rica? We've got some pretty nasty stuff here, but of the five products we've got, we'll go in order of best to worst. So far, this is the best that I've found in Costa Rica. It's Dos Pinos Choco Leche. Yeah, it's got a really fruity chocolate flavor to it, kind of a fruity sweetness. It's identifiable as chocolate, but is way more on the candied end of the spectrum. Kids might like this, but as a real chocolate milk, it's just chalky and very candy-like.
Good.
Number two, also from the Dos Pinos brand, which is a Costa Rican brand, got Fresco Leche. It's similar to that Choco Leche stuff, but it is a little bit different. The chocolate flavor here is a little bit better. The texture is a little bit chalkier. It's not terrible, it's potable. The difference between this and real chocolate milk is sort of like the difference between a fudgesicle and actual ice cream. You know, it's chocolate flavor and it's cold and all that, but it just doesn't have that same sort of flavor. It's again more on the candied end of the spectrum, but it's drinkable. All right, next best. This is actually a Nicaraguan product and it's made for Lala, Eskimo. Had a lot of Lala products in Mexico and even in the States and Hispanic supermarkets you can find it. Yeah, it's completely devoid of salt, which is its biggest drawback because it just focuses more attention on the lackluster cocoa flavor. It's kind of a dusty sort of cocoa flavor and the sweetness doesn't do anything for it. It doesn't distract either, but it's just kind of blah. This is one of the ones that comes in a six pack. Oh, there's one. Eskimo comes in like a Neapolitan pack. Vanilla, strawberry and chocolate. Hey, we'll take it. They're not selling the singles, but consider that a win.
Oh, snap. Moo.
Again, in a Neapolitan pack. That's the second, actually the third brand that we've seen with packaged strawberry, chocolate, and vanilla all in one pack. So, hey, at least there's two chocolates in there. Definitely counts. And that would be the fifth one that we've seen here in Costa Rica so far. Also, another one that comes in the six pack is this Moo. This is a product of Costa Rica. Okay, it's really starchy. It's got sort of a fermented corn type of a flavor. If you've ever been around a corn crib in late season after the harvest, you get that smell, that unmistakable smell of fermented corn. It kind of has that as a flavor, which is not really something you're looking for. It overpowers whatever chocolate's in there and the texture is crappy too. Yep. Oh. All right. Last and unfortunately least, Dos Pinos Pinitos Lula Leche. I think it's for kids. It's got a cow with a basketball on it. Oh my God. This has such a overpoweringly strong stevia flavor. It's got stevia in it and it just hammers you with it. And I'm still tasting it. You don't really register any chocolate or any other sort of flavors. It's that whole way through. It's really nasty. It's for kids. Will kids know the difference? I don't know. Side by side, I think anybody would think this is disgusting. In isolation, is it potable? Maybe for some, but not for me. This stuff's terrible. We have to bring the skunk out. Just a poop on it. Okay, so in summary, after having the last three that were pretty rough, this is what you gotta go for if you're in Costa Rica. Dos Pinos, you'll see it everywhere, but the Fresco Leche, which has probably the truest chocolate flavor of them, and the Choco Leche, which I think has the better texture, it'll get a little fruity sweetness, but yeah, I mean, remarkably drinkable after having the other three, so go with these. It's not real good. Oh my God, this stuff's terrible. Need an oral douche after that.
There you go. Game clock at 8. He's going to do it himself. Crossover. Step back. And the buzzer on a last second J. Cold-blooded.